So in this Photoshop video, I want to show you how you work with filters in Photoshop. So let me go ahead and select this layer. So this image is selected and I want to show you some of these filters and I'll show you some of the most commonly used ones. Again, I'm not going to spend too much time here, but in the last video, I showed you all the image adjustments that you could use to really work with your image and changing brightness and contrast and exposure and things like that, image size. But this video, let me show you some of the cool filters that I like using. If you select your layer and if you go to filter and if you go to artistic, these are some of the really cool things that you'll have options to play with. So let me just choose the first one, color pencil. It'll take me to this other window where I have some options with actually all the different artistic filters. So this is color pencil. And these are all the adjustments I could make with a colored pencil. So pencil width, stroke pressure. And it doesn't seem like it's really something that might be handy for this kind of image. But if you go over here, try some of the other ones. Try dry brush. That's kind of interesting. So now you could bring the detail down and you could take the brush size down and you'll get kind of an artistic look out of there. Maybe film grain. That's kind of an interesting look. Again, you could play around with all these settings. Maybe you want this at a 1, the highlight area could come up, the intensity could be lowered. Now that kind of gets you an interesting look. Again, for a professional retouching, this is not what you want to use, but these are some fun filters. And if you use them with just a subtle touch, it could get you some really cool effect. Posterizing edges, play around with some of these, see if any of these are to your liking. There's some really cool options here. So I'm just going to press cancel. So that's if you use filter and artistic. Now, one of the things I actually use the most is down here, sharpen, and this setting, sharpen. So sometimes, did you see the difference here? Let me press command Z. And let me just press command plus to zoom in. And if I go again to filter, sharpen, and sharpen. Just like that is created. Let me just press the move tool so the crop tool is not selected. Just like that, it's made the image sharper. So if your image is slightly blurry, that's one way to just make it slightly sharper just by pressing sharpen and then sharpen here. Another one is actually blurring an image. So a lot of times if I want the background to be blurred, if I'm layering a couple of things on top of each other, I'll go here, press blur, and then I'll use Gaussian Blur here. Gaussian Blur allows you to put an image out of focus. So if I wanted to put something in the foreground here, for example, I'll just say, okay, this, if you change the radius, it makes it less or more blurry. So let's say around the 3. And then if I wanted to take this, let me just close this one. If I wanted to take this transparent logo, I could just grab it, bring it right on top of this one and drop it. And let me just show you this resizing tool that comes in really handy. If you press Command T or Control T on a PC, it gives you an option to freely transform any layer. So I'll get to layers in a different video, but transforming allows you to grab a corner and just change the size of something. And it's freely letting me do what I want. Now, if I press Shift, it's going to keep the dimensions the same. The width and the height are not going to change. And they're gonna keep together. This way, I'm really gonna distort images. So I usually hold shift when I resize something. So if I wanted this to be smaller, I could do that. Again, come up here, press check mark, and then I could drag it down here. That's under edit, transform, and this allows you to do the different transforms like scale, rotate, or free transform. The shortcut I showed you allows you to do anything you want, even let you rotate things if you grab it by that side. I'm going to press Command Z to undo. It lets you change things from one side or the other side or from the corner. And if you press Shift, it keeps it all together. So that's a way to change a layer in Photoshop. I'm going to press Enter here, which is going to click this check mark. I could do the same thing with an image. So this image here, I'm pressing Command T and I could go ahead and resize this image just like that. Again, hold Shift. So it keeps the height and the width the same, and you could resize things just like that. Again, press enter. So those are the main things I use under filter. There's a bunch of other things. There's stylizing, there's sketches, there's even pixelating things. Let me just show you a pixelation. That'll give you that kind of effect. If I pressed okay, I'm gonna press Command Z. So there's a lot of filters here to play around with. There's even this one, Liquify. Let me just show you that real quick. So you could just grab something and distort it. again, I'm really exaggerating what's possible with this, but I'm going to press Command Z. But if you wanted to do subtle retouching in Photoshop, like if I wanted to make her face longer, just very, very subtle things. Now, this is a huge size brush here. If I go over here and reduce the brush size to like a 40, I could do really subtle things. I could just make her finger longer, things like that with the Liquify tool. And that's one of the other options under Filter Liquify. So a lot of things to play around here. If you go to the Filter Gallery, like I showed you before, you could do some of the artistic things here. Some of the brush strokes are under here. And some of the things that you could use to distort the image. A lot of different options that you could play around with here. I'm just going to cancel. So Filter Gallery gives you a lot of other options. And you could even go online to see even more options than what comes with Photoshop out of the box. Now, in the next video, I want to go over and talk about layers, because layers is where you spend a lot of your time. So far, we've kind of skipped over layers, but layers have gotten created as we're making these videos. But let me just really spend some time in this layer panel just to show you what's possible in this area of Photoshop. Again, please give this video a thumbs up and stay tuned for the next video. See you there.